She don't care, we like almost there, the right vibe. Ready to get live, ain't no surprise. Take me so high, jumping those dives, surfing the crowd. Ooh, said I gotta be the man, I'm the head of my band. Mic check, 1, 2. Shut them down in the club where the Playboy does. So they all get loose, loose, out the bottle. We all get fit in again tomorrow. Gotta break rules, cause that's the motto. Club shut down, 100 supermodels.
Hey, took your home and be a home run. Show me how you do. I wanna shut down the club with you. Hey, I heard you like the wild ones, wild ones, wild ones. Party rocker for showstopper.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see.
Today on David Attenborough, we'll be looking at the wild in its colour. He's quite a small creature, and protects me a sheep. He is mentally challenged due to he is not a sheep. He is a rare breed of a bear. He is not that hairy, but
his Latin term is smallest boyus.
Yes. He is from the dinosaur era, but survived the comet. We will be back to you on the
other day. Yeah, Matthew is full, as you can see.
Tell him!
And we all are.
Stop it, Louis!
From, eating Cullum. This is what's left for the poor boy. Oh well. Well, yes, eating Cullum.
Welcome back to David Attenborough. This creature is related to the smallest boyest. It is a female and seems to be sleeping. As you can see, she is holding water. She may be thirsty. As you can see, she also has no style due to her heart is awful. Also, she is broken. I'm about to run. See you back on the exact question. Today on David Attenborough's show, we'll be looking at the very tallest to the quite tallest. They are very large animals. The one on the right is the tallest. At around 6'2", it could break a branch, such as this one. We found it early today. The very tallest is quite a calm animal. Try to sort out his bag. And I mean the carrying bag. It seems to have milk, if you look down there. Oh, and he takes the milk. Ah, seems to be a battle going on here. Milk. You cannot have the milk. As you can see here, it spoke to me. I'm gonna see if it can talk to me again. Very tallest! Okay, it has spoken. Ooh, there was porridge. Nice porridge. I'm going to get close to the very tallest.
That's nice.
Never mind. We will see you later today.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Bear Grylls. I'm filling in for David Attenborough. As you can see, in the distance, we have the not as tallest as the verest tallest, a distant cousin of the verest tallest. Now, I know this show is against killing animals, but I'm feeling a bit peckish.
Watch out!
Someone just wanted to punch me.
You're not
going to
die.
I did not
punch
him all over.
There we go. Somebody asked for the way. Go! Today on David Attenborough, we'll be looking at the very Regis. He is very angry and has some problems with his mind. He seems to think he is the best at everything, but it gets too hard for him, he quits. He seems to be looking at sheep. I don't know what he's thinking of, but it's not a good thing. I wonder. Did he have a bar? He'd die. See you later on David Attenborough.
Go on, Tom.
I'm recording it.
Oh my god, that, yeah.
Oh, sorry. Is this cold?
I know.
It's not cold.
Yeah, I did. It sounds wrong.
I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you. When I go out, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. If I get drunk, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who gets drunk next to you. And if I heaver, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's heavering to you. But I would walk 500 miles and I would walk 500 more than be the man who walked 1,000 miles to fall down at your door. But I'm watching, cause I know I'm gonna be.
Back to Davy. Oh yeah, it's a little bit rain. Might put the camera in a little bit for cover. Put the map away in my coat because boy won't let me put it inside the half cover. Everyone in the group's falling out because saw went the wrong way a bit. Blaming it on people. As I say, it's a group activity, don't blame anybody. Ah, well. Well, we'll try and get back on course now. And I'll get back to you.
And Cornelius and Christina just disappeared into thin air. And their bag is at the top of the floor. And everybody starts to argue whoever gets first. Hi. You and one?
Who's next? Matthew, Christina, and oh wait, no, Christina. Then probably Cornelius, then Matthew and me. What? But go, Math. Almost there.
Matthew, come through it like I did.
Oh! Oh. Good Colin. Now my turn.
This could be embarrassing.
My feet are full of water. Run, Tom, run! You like him done.
Fuck, I see.
Wait, get the camera recording, recording. Yeah. Recording
now. And here comes the adults.
Oh.
That's
not
dead.
Oh, so you know the way. I just went
there and
I'm
come next
to the straight ahead!
The video to see you fall.
Straight ahead!
Whoa!
Straight ahead!
Aww. Cheated. That's one. One. And two. And three. So, we've made it to our other checkpoint. So, when Sewelli or whichever. Well, I think some of this is getting to us, so don't worry.
No, not too much. It's just my shoes are now
so. I wonder who's what that is. So, that's Kieran. And. Christina, Matthew, and good crap, I forgot his name for some reason. Cornelius and Miss, myself. Still a missing colour. And we're back at the camp. Congratulations to us for the first night. And yeah. So basically yeah. Alright, I'll see you tonight.
Today on David Attenborough, we have encountered the flat stratus. Its usual dominancy is in the hedges to the left and the right of the road, but it appears to have stumbled into new territory of the Vauxhall Vectress, which has appeared to flatten the thing. We shall eat it later with some side of cricket. We will return.
And Christina says to walk across this very muddy path. You can make it. not. Well done.
I am cow, hear me moo. I weigh twice as much as you, and I look good on the barbecue. Yogurt, curd, cream, cheese, and butter's made from liquid from my udders. I am cow, hear me moo. I am cow.